Alkis Bano, a survivor of one of the most brutal crimes during the 2002 Gujarat riots, expressed joy as the Supreme Court declared truly the new year for her. The 11 men responsible for killing her family and subjecting her to gang rape are set to return to prison after the court ruled that their release last year based on good behavior was unjust. The Supreme Court emphasized that the Gujarat government's decision to release the convicts lacked thoughtful consideration, stating that only the state where the trial occurred, Maharashtra in this instance, has the authority to make such decisions. The court further ordered the convicts to surrender within 2 weeks. I have wept tears of relief. I smiled for the first time in over a year and a half. I've hugged my children. It feels like a stone the size of a mountain has been lifted from my chest and I can breathe again, Bilkis Bano said in a statement issued through her lawyer Shobha Gupta. This is what justice feels like. I thank the Honorable Supreme Court of India for giving me, my children and women everywhere this vindication and hope in the promise of equal justice for all, she said. A year and a half ago, on August 15, 2022, when those who had destroyed my family and terrorized my very existence were given an early release, I simply collapsed, she said. To those who stood with her during that period, my gratitude for your precious solidarity and strength, she said. You gave me the will to struggle, to rescue the idea of justice, not just for me, but for every woman in India. I thank you, Bilkis Bano added. Shobha Gupta, Bilkis Bano's legal counsel for decades, reflected on the situation, stating, "It was as if a decision was made first and the process applied later, and if I dare say, unmindfully." She also raised questions about the cited good behavior of the released men, saying, "What was the reflection of the good behavior? Nothing was reflecting. The release of the men on Independence Day last year by the Gujarat government, utilizing an outdated law, triggered widespread outrage across the country." Bilkis Bano revealed that she was not informed about the release and expressed deep concern about the significant risk it posed to her security. Upon their release, the men received a hero's welcome, complete with sweets and garlands. Shockingly, some of them were later observed sharing the stage with the BJP MP and MLA, adding to the controversy surrounding their release. During the court hearing, it was disclosed that Radhesham Shah, the convict who initiated the petition for release, had even resumed practicing law, an unsettling revelation that further fueled the scrutiny of the entire release process.